Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. So today it's gonna be the review of the latest build of AOSIP ROM based on Android 8.1.0 Oreo for the Redmi Note 3. So without any further ado, let's get started. One step is all it takes to get us moving anywhere. And now that we are on our way, I need to say what used to keep us back were just excuses made to not change. So here is my Redmi Note 3 running the AOSIP ROM latest build, and yeah guys, everything remains pretty much similar except some things like the battery life and performance, which I'll be telling you in the later part, so do watch this video until the end. And yeah, I also had a battery drain kinda issue, so I'll be talking about all those things in the later part. And talking about the system UI, here is the system UI that comes with the AOSIP ROM, pretty much similar to the previous build. I have reviewed all the features like camera features, customization options, like everything in the previous builds, so the link would be in the description. Go ahead and watch that video if you want details about all those things. So here is the Pixel Launcher working perfectly fine, and yeah, a couple of settings of Pixel Launcher. As you can see, you can go through this. I have already reviewed all this thing, and double tap to sleep works perfectly fine, as you can see, but no double tap to wake like the AEX ROM. And seriously guys, AEX ROM is much better than this one, so I'll also be comparing those ROMs in the later part. And here are a couple of applications that comes pre-installed with this ROM. As you can see, apart from AnTuTu Benchmark and Google Play Music, all these applications came pre-installed with this ROM. I have installed Play Music because this ROM didn't came with any music player pre-installed. Yes, you heard me right, I didn't had any music player installed in this ROM. That's why I went ahead and installed the Play Music. And I have flashed the GApps Nano, by the way. It is working perfectly fine. So talking about the camera application, as you can see, here is the camera app working perfectly fine. But yeah, after the first boot, it was giving force closures. Yes, you heard me right. After like 2 to 3 reboots, now it is working perfectly fine. I didn't had any force closures. So from here, you can change from camera to video. All the features are present here, as you can see, and all of them are working perfectly fine, no issues with that. So talking about the video recording, here is the video recording. By default it comes on 1080p, you can go all the way up to 4K or come down to HD 720p, and the stabilization thing is also present, but it doesn't make a really big difference when it is on or off. So that was regarding the camera application. So let me show you the settings menu really quick, the about device section. And the AOSIP updater is there, but as you can see, it is not showing here. It's black, and I don't have an internet connection now. And at the time of recording this video, this was the latest build. That's why I couldn't check the AOSIP updater. But for the previous builds, it was working fine. I don't know about this build. If anybody wants that, then comment it down. I'll reply to you. And here is the about device section. As you can see, AOSIP ROM. The build date is 2/5/2018, and the security patch remains the same, 5/April/2018. The kernel also remains the same, the Dominator kernel, and the vendor mismatch thing didn't appear in this build. Thankfully, it was coming in the previous build, the error, but not in this one. And talking about the security and lock screen, fingerprint scanner and all other screen lock types are working perfectly fine, but unfortunately I didn't get the face ID. As you can see, only one thing is present, on body detection. I have flashed the GApps Nano as I told you earlier, but some people also reported that they had flashed micro GApps and mini GApps. The face ID was there for them. I think that's because of the GApps, but I don't know what is the reason behind not getting face unlock in the Nano, as some other ROMs were getting that. Location sensor also works perfectly fine, no issues with GPS. So some of my subscribers were telling me to test it out using an application. Sorry guys, I didn't have much time in order to test this. But yeah, I had tried the Google Maps, and Google Maps was working perfectly fine. I didn't have any issues. So talking about the display option, here are a couple of things that comes with this ROM. Pretty much similar, ambient display is present here. You can enable that if you want. And the night light is also there, working perfectly fine, as you can see. And And here are a couple of customization options, and you can enable on-screen navigation buttons from here. They work perfectly fine, no issues with them. But I seriously don't like the on-screen navigation buttons. I kinda like the hardware keys, that's why I keep them disabled like for all the time. And you can customize your hardware keys from here. You can enable advanced reboot. I have enabled this one. And as always, I have reviewed all these customization options in my previous ROM review videos. The link would be in the description. And Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, etc. Everything is working perfectly fine. I didn't had any issues regarding them, and it should work fine for you guys as well. So let me show you my last AnTuTu score, and finally AnTuTu benchmark is running in this build. Yes, you heard me right. The previous build was giving random reboots when I was running AnTuTu benchmark, but this build was running. But yeah, it was not that easy to run AnTuTu on this one. Even this thing was giving force close. I mean this build, it was just getting freezed while running AnTuTu 3D. But after like continuous tries, like 4 to 5 times, the 6th time it worked and it gave me a score of 87,865, which is not that great, but yeah, it is not that worst as well. Talking about performance, performance is good but not the best what I have seen. In terms of performance, AEX ROM is definitely better than this one, the 29th April build which I reviewed recently. I termed it as the best Oreo ROM for the Redmi Note 3 in 2018, the Oreo ROM, and yes it is. The AEX ROM 29th April build is the best ROM for the Redmi Note 3 Kenzo, at least till now. So gaming performance is also good but not the best. It was giving lags in some of the games and minor glitches here and there, but it is playable, not the worst or anything like that. And talking about the battery life was not that great guys. It remains pretty much similar, but an unusual thing happened to me in this build. When I first booted this ROM on my device and the battery was around 48%, in order to test the screen on time, I charged this thing all the way to 100% and later used some games like the Subway Surfers, and I played some music which is present on my device, and also used YouTube for a while, which I uninstalled later. And the charge was down to around 92%, and yeah, it is usual, even in the previous build it was same. But the standby time was worst guys, you will not believe me. From 92% it went all the way down to 70% in just 3 to 4 hours. Yes, you heard me right. I don't know what was that, but yeah, I know that the ROM, AOSIP ROM, is not that worst. So I kept it for standby overnight, and you'll not believe what I'll tell. The phone was just switched off when I got up in the morning, like 6 a.m. The phone was switched off, charge was on 0%, like it drained 70% of battery overnight. It was just ridiculous. That's why I retested this ROM, I mean I recharged this thing to 100%, and after that the standby time was really good. It was just draining around 10% overnight. I don't know why was that, but yeah, I had to tell that. It was not my device fault guys, because in the AEX ROM it was working absolutely fine, and even in all other ROMs it is working perfectly fine. And by the way, this is a new Redmi Note 3, not the old one. I purchased this recently like a year ago and I didn't use this much, so no issues with my device. But I'm telling you again, after the 100% charge the second time, now it is working perfectly fine. The standby time is also really good. The screen on time remains pretty much similar, 4 hours 45 minutes to 5 hours for me, and screen on time will differ from user to user, do note that. So talking about the comparison of AOSIP, AEX, Lineage OS, Resurrection Remix, AEX 29 April build is amazing. You can definitely use that ROM as your daily driver, and I'm gonna switch to AEX ROM from this build because it is much more better in terms of performance, battery life and everything else, and it has some usual features like the double tap to sleep, double tap to wake, and yeah, all other things. I have reviewed that ROM earlier, so the link would be in the description again. So that was regarding the review of latest build of AOSIP ROM based on Android 8.1.0 for the Redmi Note 3 Kenzo. So that's pretty much it for this video guys. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up and do subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. This is All About Technology 24/7, signing off for the moment. You guys have a great day. Peace.